coming to you live from Stairway to Heaven Arena in beautiful downtown Purgatory. And it's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll.
Hey, I'll just turn you into some generic classic rock DJ dipshit. That's the best you can come up with for an intro. How about a nice simple, here's the fucking kickoff.
The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for NFL action. The Lost Wages Invaders battle the Full Metal Mayhem. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you're just waking up wondering who put that vice on your head and filled your mouth with vacuum cleaner, dirt, and cat litter, you're not alone. After all, it's Sunday, NFL game day. Hey, you look tired, Junior. And Bricks, you look like they just used your head in field goal practice.
Spent all night in the ER. We ate Chinese food last night.
Food poisoning?
I wish. I got the chopsticks lodged in my ears again. You know, they should have a warning on them things.
Second down and more than the QB would like. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and 10. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. First down and 7. Great catch, and that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Never mind. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Bert. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Hot one.
Oh, nice hit. And 4.
Hot 1, hot 2, hot 3.
They weren't even on the same page on that play. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he's got a chance for a good... Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right. sure now he catches it.
I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
And it's first and ten. That's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Tired of the quarterback's tight spirals, and the whistle blows the play dead, along with the quarterback. First down and three. Second down and a lot. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
It's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
It's 2 yard run before he stopped. Third down and three.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
The defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3 yard gain on that pass. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. Nice punt. Should move him back. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, man. He just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and ten. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Do we have a rule book?
It's propping up your chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
They're back up here on first, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile. That's a 4 yard gain. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Third down and the punter is warming up. And the defense gave up a lot of yards on that pass play. Quickly. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Man, what a hit that was. And that'll be second and eight to go.
Hot one. Hot two. Hot eight.
Oh, that was a vicious hit. There might not be an eye in team, but this guy's eyeballs are all over the other team's helmets right now. And it's first and ten. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
One, hot two, hot three.
And the defense was reading him like a book.
Like it was written in Braille, Grim. His hands were...
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten. Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and six. I hope you covered your ears, Briggs, because that was a Sonic Blast dirty trick. That ball just broke the sound. Caught for the first down. And it's first and ten. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. First down and one. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It's good. The The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and ten.
Seriously, stay in drugs, eat school, and don't do vegetables.
Junior's having a flashback, man. What do we do?
Down him talk so he out it comes up. Second down in a very line.
One, hot two. Hot.
And it's your mother ever tell you don't run with a chance. Someone who knows they can negotiate for more money next year.
I call that shake, rattle, and bone.
And they line up for the extra point. Kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and ten. And that takes us to the 2-minute warning. And it's first and ten. Defense gives up 5 yards there. And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just gonna take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play. You can't keep a good mutant down.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
Third down and eight. The quarterback burns his last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore. And it's first and ten. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls play. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth, I...
The timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Oh,
man.
Oh, with the brain scrambler. First down and six.
Hey, timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. You've got to catch that. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up?
And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. He could probably be a better dancer if he went to dance class, but as you can see, he doesn't have the stomach for it. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten. And he pounds the ball into the defense, picking up seven. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We are back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. They're going to be able to return this one. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about bad hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and ten.
Hot, hot one, hot two.
Say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol, narcotics, or insanity to anyone, but they've always worked for me. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one.
First and 10. Second down in a very lot. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Third down and 6. That pass play was good for 3 yards. There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. And chainsaws really have a way of extending the range. Going for it, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. Rainbow. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my offseason.
And it's first and 10. That run is good for 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and 1.
He hit that line the way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and 10. Broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody let him.
This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
First and 2. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Ouch! What is this, wrestling?
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
That would have been a disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Second down and nine. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Third down and five.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And the cornerback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I wanna see if the little bastard's crying.
Punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of 3 returns.
Don't you get the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and ten. He runs it for three. Second down and seven. Third down and long. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit. The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over.
I got the thing stuck in my ear again.
Team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Hot two.
Oh, he just got crushed. Second down and long. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Third down and five. Oh, with the brutal hit.
I don't understand. Why are they going for it, Grim? This seems like the situation where they should always, always...
Well, just when I thought only noobs would go for it on fourth for no real reason, they convert. But did they just get really lucky? Stay tuned. It's first and ten. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. Second and three.
Hot one.
No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was on to the races. And here comes the extra point attempt. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. And that is caught for a first down. First down and 5. Put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chick wearing a...
Oh, it's a punishing hit. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Britz's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex.
He could be. He might be. He is gone. He is not coming back. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stupsing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
And then catch will give them a first down.
But he sure has a good set of hands.
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Okay, nice and easy like a two-foot putt.
You miss two-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. It's first and 10. Oh, and the defense jumps outside to attack the QB. And in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. And it's first and 10. They're taking what the defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wipe with a headache.
Second down and 6. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Second down and a lot. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Look at that freak. He's unstoppable!
Oh, good run. He nearly broke it open, Bricks.
Yeah, and I nearly blew 3 times the legal limit last night leaving the stadium. And I nearly did not get arrested, get thrown face first into a paddy wagon, get taken for a rough ride. And I nearly did not.
No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense.
Hot two.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts, so you can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's Matt's stuffing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
Nicely done for a first down. First, they've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game.
One, hot two, eight.
Second down, and that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was Izzy.
Talking about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. He scores! He earned those points on the heels of an epic run. want kids to think I'm cool. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
He'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. First and 10. And that's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Second down and 2. He picks up a 2. Solid win, and the opposition will be licking their wounds on the long plane ride home.
I heard wounds taste just like chicken. How was it? Scrambles tomato soup. I forget, but a good scab tastes like bacon. That I know.
A scab lettuce tomato sandwich. Sounds like a picnic. And the MVP is about to inspire us with some words of wisdom. Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every up.